My name is Sunny Chinnapati. I'm a fourth year medical student at Vanderbilt University School of Medicine. My mentor is Dr. Virginia Plans at Vanderbilt University Medical Center. I will be presenting on a case of lithium-induced nephropathy as the RSNA Case Collection Case of the Week. To start with the history, this patient is a 74-year-old female with bipolar disorder and a remote history of lithium use over 20 years ago who presents for a routine evaluation of chronic kidney disease. Her physical exam was unremarkable. Her labs are notable for a serum creatinine of 1.28, a GFR of 41, and a urinalysis within normal limits. The left image is an axial contrast-enhanced CT scan through the abdomen in the nephrographic phase and showcases multiple hypoattenuating foci in both kidneys, denoted by the blue arrows. The same finding is also found in the coronal CT image on the right. This long-axis grayscale ultrasound through the left kidney obtained 4 years later shows numerous echogenic foci, marked by blue arrows, throughout the renal parenchyma. This transverse grayscale CINI through the right kidney shows multiple echogenic foci dispersed throughout the renal parenchyma. The image on the right is a still taken from the CINI. The final diagnosis in this case was lithium-induced nephropathy. This condition presents as numerous punctate non-shadowing hyperechoic foci that are uniform in size and distribution throughout the renal parenchyma bilaterally, consistent with microcysts. In contrast to the anechoic appearance of simple renal cysts, the microcysts associated with lithium-induced nephropathy appear hyperechoic due to their small size of 1 to 2 millimeters. Axial and coronal contrast-enhanced CT through the kidneys in the nephrographic phase both show the microcysts as hypoattenuating foci throughout the renal parenchyma. The differential diagnosis for lithium-induced nephropathy includes the following conditions. Simple renal cysts are anechoic, have well-defined thin walls, and show posterior acoustic enhancement deep to the lesion. Medullary cystic kidney disease features smaller kidneys due to progressive fibrosis, as well as numerous small cysts that are generally isolated to the medulla and corticomedullary conjunction. Urolithiasis appears as an echogenic focus with posterior shadowing and twinkle artifact on color Doppler, usually located centrally in the kidney near or within the renal sinus. To conclude, lithium-induced nephropathy is the first consideration in cases of many renal microcysts in a patient with a history of chronic lithium therapy. Sonography shows numerous microcysts represented by punctate, non-shadowing, hyperechoic foci within the renal cortex and medulla, symmetrically involving both kidneys and measuring 1 to 2 millimeters. Treatment of lithium's adverse effects often begins with dosage adjustments if the concentration is near the upper boundary of the therapeutic range. Thank you for allowing us to present our work.